Welcome. In this tutorial, we will graphically solve this minimization problem using the objective function line approach. Note that the use of the graphical approach is limited to two decision variables. We start by finding points for the constraint lines. Let's label them C1 to C3 for reference purposes. For constraint 1, when x equals 0, y equals 2. And when y equals 0, x equals 6. For constraint 2, when x equals 0, y equals 5, and when y equals 0, x equals 2. For constraint 3, y is just always less than or equal to 4, irrespective of the value of x. In drawing the graph, note here that the highest value of x is 6, and the highest value of y is 5. And that is what tells us how far we need to go on the x and y axis. You can see that I went a little bit higher than 6 on the x axis, and a little bit more than 5 in the y-axis because I have the space. So drawing the line for the first constraint, we have the points 0, 2, and 6, 0, which we join to form the constraint line. For the second constraint, we have 0, 5, and 2, 0, which we also join to form the constraint line. For y less than or equal to 4, the line is simply at y equals 4. Now, since the first two constraints are greater than constraints, they will be satisfied in the region above the lines away from the origin, and y less than or equal to 4 is simply satisfied below the line. The direction of the arrows show that the region satisfying all the constraints at the same time, called the feasible region, is this area shaded in blue. Now, the optimal solution to this problem will occur at an extreme or corner point of this feasible region. Let's label them A, B, and C for reference purposes. Now, recall that the objective function is to minimize 5x plus 7y. So the corner points that gives us the minimum value of the objective function is the optimal point. Instead of testing every single point, we will use the objective function line approach. We begin by setting the objective function to any number of our choice. To make the process easy, we can simply multiply the coefficients of x and y. In this example, we have 5 times 7, which equals 35. 35 seems to be appropriate for this problem. Note that if this number is too small or too large, you can always multiply or divide it by an appropriate value. Next, we find the points to draw the objective function line. When x equals 0, y equals 5, and when y equals 0, x equals 7. So the objective function line is this blue dotted line here. Recall that this is a minimization problem. So to use this line to determine the best extreme point, we slowly move it down towards the origin parallel to itself. If this were a maximization problem, we will move the line upwards away from the origin. The last extreme point the line touches before leaving the feasible region is the optimal solution point. So let's slowly move the objective function line parallel to itself. You can see here that it passes A and C, so it is obvious that point B is the optimal solution point. We now need to solve the two lines that intersect at point B simultaneously to determine the coordinates at that point. Here are the equations. Let's use the substitution method. From C1, we can write x in terms of y to give x equals 6 minus 3y. We can then substitute that expression into C2, and that simplifies to 30 minus 15y plus 2y equals 10, which gives negative 13 equals negative 20, and that gives y equals 1.54. Substituting that y value in the x equation, we have x equals 6 minus 3 times 1.54, that is, x equals 1.38. So the coordinates at point B are x equals 1.38 and y equals 1.54. Let's now plug the points into the objective function. We have 5 times 1.38 plus 7 times 1.54, which gives 17.7. So the optimal solution occurs at point B, and the corresponding minimum value of the objective function is 17.7. See you in the next video, and thanks for watching.